estamos de volta com a exclusiva, com a sua santidade, o mestre Gyawan Drukpa. E, bom, vamos retomar aqui com nossas perguntas. Agora eu vou mais no sentido de saber como é que a gente consegue pegar essas ideias do Love to Love e de outras ideias budistas e aplicar na nossa vida hoje em dia, do mundo moderno, da correria do dia a dia.
What I am doing, this is I can tell you this. What I am doing and what my followers does is maybe it is a very small contribution, very small. I mean, compared to, you know, how many billions of people we have in this world. I mean, this is just nothing, but a handful of people who are following my example. What we do is like a so-called patyatra, which means a walking tour, walking trek, you know, trek. And I take maybe 1,000 people for trekking. And for months, we just trek. And then we just clean if there is any sort of like, what do you call that, non-biodegradable items thrown in a wild place or something. Then we pick those things up and we recycle. And we walk around in the Himalaya regions and many places. Hopefully we will do same thing in Brazil one time anyway, with the help of Brazilian people and Brazilian, really my friend and heart friend and heart students. They may be able to sort of like participate, and they will set up a good example for the rest of the Brazilian people and even to the government also. So you know, so this is this sort of thing we do just to set up an example. So and then the example will be followed by maybe many people, and they will be copying, so to speak, and so that the slowly by slowly, the how do you say, the nature will be very nourished, and all these non-biodegradable items such as plastics and, you know, bottles and whatnot, you know, all these non-biodegradable items that kills the human being, that kills the animals and kills the water and nature, all these things will be sort of finished or will be reused and recycled and treated nicely. So this is what small contribution I would say that we Live to Love do for the world.
Ainda um pouco nessa questão do mundo de hoje, do mundo moderno, o que você acha desses tempos tecnicistas em que o ser humano precisa estar sempre produzindo, nunca pode falhar, tem que dessa produção meio fordista, assim? O que você poderia nos falar sobre isso?
Yeah, you said it very correctly. You know, the people are very much after money. Of course, we all love money anyway. that's not a problem. But of course, along with the sense of love, money. But I think we have to have a bit of understanding how really how important the life is. And so, of course, for example, the non-biodegradable items, really, which is really the killer of the environment. These items are produced by those people who are very much greedy. You know, they are very greedy. You know, and running after the money. So then they produce, as you said. And then, of course, till it really like spoils all the water, till it spoils entire earth, and till it spoils all the, even air also, for example, the air we breathe and air we really sort of like deal with, are contaminated, polluted, because producing, too much product that we are producing. So this creates a lot of problems in the world. So now what I'm really, the bottom line thinking is that we have to educate. That is the area that we are talking about, education. We're not saying you have to learn Portuguese or English or French or something. This is of course this is of course an education, an aspect of our education, but that's not the thing that we are talking about. When we talk, Live to Love talks about the education, we are talking about the how important to educate, how important the natures are, how important, I mean, to educate even the rich people, how, you know, the multi-billion companies, the owner, they should know, they should be educated also, that how to behave. Of course, we're not saying that they shouldn't make money, but how to make money and how to make use of the money that they have made, you know? So multi-billion owners, multi-billion company owners and runner and founder, they should also be educated. And then the government, the politicians should be educating nicely. And also the parents should be educating nicely. And then the children should be educating nicely. So these kind of education that really serves the beings and save the nature. So these are very much the education that I'm talking about. That needs to be there. Otherwise, we talk a lot, but we will never be able to bring some sort of a decision or some fruit on our table. There's nothing. We talk a lot. I mean, the government nowadays, of course, all the politicians, they talk about the nature and all this important just to get their own, you know, the people's attention. That's all. But when they does it, the corruption comes, and then that's it. Nothing really works. Of course, there are few things are working, but nothing that much. So therefore, you know, really the education is very important. When you have education, then literally corruption will also be less, because the education is so strong. Corruption will be like a little shameful kind of area to think about. So people will be less involved in corruption.
Bem, dentre outras, além da campanha do Live to Love, do lançamento do livro, de palestras sobre meditação, etc., você também é conhecido como por iniciar uma campanha de universalização do budismo para as mulheres, né? Você pode falar um pouco para a gente, sua santidade, como surgiu a ideia, qual a importância dessa ação? E quais são essas ações que vocês têm utilizado para fazer essa desmasculinização do processo da tradição budista? Você pode falar um pouco para a gente, sua santidade?
Actually, if the woman is not respected, the world is not really going to be that much of positive. So therefore, generally speaking, we all should be respecting the woman. For the reason why that the woman has a beautiful, energy and wisdom that they can share, and they can sort of contribute to us or to this planet, to this world. And since they have a beautiful contribution, or they have a beautiful quality that they can contribute, why can't we sort of like let them to share with us? That is the simple question. that I have been asking to myself since quite a long time. Anyway, when I was very young, you know, I was always keep on thinking that why can't we sort of why do we means men suppressing or you know like hide the all the women family members at the backyard, and men always comes in the front. Why is it so that we should be doing this all the time? I'm always asking questions, and I can't see any reason why. I mean, I can't find any reason why it should be done that way. And also historically speaking, all the most of, not all, but most of the disasters, like wars and or disasters, whatever disasters that we created in this world or it has happened in this world, are mostly created by men, not by women. I mean, to my understanding, maybe I'm wrong. So of course, and of course many things that maybe many good things, many positive things also must have done by men also. But the most of the negative part, like wars and etc., all are created by men, I think. And for example, right now, all the killing things, most of the killing things done by men, not by women. So therefore, I am saying, I should be working for gender equality. So this is what I have been sort of telling myself, and I finally sort of I vow myself to work for that and dedicate my energy towards that.
Bom, o Brasil é um dos países que é muito forte no catolicismo. Entretanto, o budismo tem crescido bastante, né? Inclusive já tem até a presença de monjas, né? Mulheres monjas. Gostaria que o senhor pudesse falar para a gente um pouco sobre esse crescimento do budismo e, por final, deixar uma palavra de sabedoria para a gente, por gentileza.
I'm very happy to hear that the Catholic religion has been very successfully growing and successfully sort of settled very nicely. And I'm 100% sure that Catholic religion did manage to do do so many good work for the well-beings of people and well-beings of nature and well-beings of government and country itself. I'm sure. I'm 100% sure that there's no doubt about it. But and also I'm quite happy that now people are also sort of like knowing more about the Buddhism also, because the Buddhism also is just how do you say another angles of wisdom to serve the people and beings, not only people but the animals. Not only animal, but the nature, you know? And because, as I mentioned before, Buddhism is very much for the nature, because the nature is so important for generations and generations of people for the future. If the natures are not there, we will not be survived. And if the animals are not there, we will not be survived. So the animals need to be respected. We cannot abuse the animal. We cannot kill the animal for money, you know? Just for money we kill. For example, just for money we kill rhinos. And then because this, you know, the thing that it's coming from the rhinos, so that we kill him. Or the elephant. And all these beautiful animals, just for making money, you kill and you finish the animal. So this is not right. Wild animals are not respected for some reason, because we think we have to make money, so by killing them. So it's very bad. So we have to respect them. So with them, we will be able to sort of live comfortably and harmoniously. So we have to really live harmonious with the animal, with the nature, with everything, with woman, with man, everything. We have to really live harmoniously. So this is what the message of the Buddhism. So of course, people, I'm very happy that the people are also sort of starting to understand the value of the Buddhism also. But since Buddhism is not a religion, as the Buddhism is it's the way to develop one's own day-to-day life. It's just a way, that's all. This is not a religion. So it can be practiced along with the Catholicism. There's no problem, you know. Catholic practice can be done along with the Buddhist understanding. It's not a problem at all. And I mean, to my understanding, it shouldn't be any problem. For example, live to love can be done by anybody. It's not, oh, specifically it should be done by the Buddhist people. No, it can be practiced by non-religious people also, or non-believer also, you know. The people who doesn't believe anything can practice the live to love, because live to love is something to give service to the world. That's all. We're not really thinking about a religion. Any religion is not involved. No religion is involved in live to love. So my final sort of a word or suggestion or advice to the Brazilian is that, of course, as I mentioned, we should live very harmoniously, not only with the friends and with family, but with animals, and not only with the animal, but eventually what we really have to know is how important to live harmoniously with the nature. And we should try to put our effort to make the nature healthy, so that we will be able to live and turn this world into pleasant place to live, not only for our generation, but generations to come. Thank you.
Eu que agradeço pelo privilégio de poder ter entrevistado Sua Santidade, Mestre Gyawon Drukpa. Fico muito feliz mesmo, uma oportunidade engrandecedora. E ficamos por aqui com mais essa exclusiva para a UNB TV. E continue ligado na nossa programação.